After climbing up to the castle itself, this morning it was time to see what makes Takeda Castle famous. If you head to the viewing spot on the other side of the valley early in the morning, and if the conditions are just right, the mist will make the castle look like it's floating in the sky.
It's 5:15 in the morning. I can see the mist already. My buddy here, I think his name's Nicholas. We're gonna go 40 minutes to the parking lot, get up there. Oh man, this is perfect. That middle character is clouds, so I think that's what the pictures are. Yeah.
Ritsuunkyo Valley.
That's it.
That's it, alright, cool. Wow, we picked a perfect day, man. No, we're definitely not alone.
It's always kind of disappointing when you get up this early in the morning and other people are up too. You're like, damn it, I wanted to be the only one up. I hope this view is worth this final climb up because this is pretty steep. Yeah, once again, I don't really feel like words are necessary. Just enjoy the view as I am. This is also a very popular spot. Look at the number of people. So there was another little offshoot past the top, so we came down here to explore. There's a little hut. Yeah, I think we both agree that that was definitely worth it.
Definitely.
Get up at 5. Did we get up at 5? We did, right?
Yes.
Get up at 5, climb up there. That's perfect. All right, goodbye Fukunai House. It was lovely staying here. If you come to this place, definitely recommend it. I think they got some lemons. I won't steal those.
Bye.
Okay, that was fantastic. Nicholas, very nice meeting you. I hope we see each other again in the future. Now, I need to take the train back to Tokyo. That is quite a distance. But first I need to go to Himeji or Osaka. I'm not sure which. I'll check the directions here and the train times. But it's also possible I could be waiting here a while. Okay, looks like the bus is my best option. The bus should be here in like 10 minutes. Okay, this is the bus stop. Train stop is right there. Bus leaves in about 7 minutes. The bus will head towards Wadayama Eki, which is like quite a few bus stops north. And then we're gonna take the train back south, then the Shinkansen east. So in total, probably like 5 hours of travel. I'll get there like 2 or 3 p.m. Unfortunately, the trains out in the countryside, they're much further in between, so I've got almost an hour wait for the next train. Nice waiting area though, at least. Oh, I kind of feel like garbage. Lack of sleep. Fighting off a sickness that I probably had before I left. And Japanese cuisine strangely lacking vegetables. Like, there's just not that many vegetables, like fresh green vegetables that you eat. I feel like I need to just go to the grocery store, buy some vegetables and just like eat them raw. Yeah, going back to Tokyo for a much needed break will be nice tonight. These countryside train stations, they have such a particular feel to them because they're always empty. Oh man, it's just like, it's a particular feeling of being lost, but kind of not at the same time. I don't know. Train arrives in 10 minutes or so. And I'm the only one out here.
I feel kind of terrible. I think the next train to Tokyo goes in 30 minutes, so I need to go get a ticket. Oh man, not enough sleep. Not eating properly. Not a good idea. Do it for today's vlog. My stomach, man, is still kind of cramping a little bit. Also, public transportation makes you think that you can go anywhere and do anything in a single day, and then next thing you know, you've been on trains or in train stations for 8 hours and you're like, oh, maybe this wasn't such a great idea. Anyways, I'll see you in the next one if I survive. Ran right into that spider just hanging from the ceiling. It's that feeling of being lost. Dude, why is all these spiders hanging from the ceiling? Good God. Okay, I'm back. Oh, my stomach. My stomach. Whew. Kinda hurts.